Which of these is the most important factor when it comes to delivering the presentation? Is it the message? Or is it the delivery style? Or is it the structure? Or audience connection? I will answer this question at the end of this video. So try as much as you can to stay until the end of the video. Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Rashid and welcome back to Epic Mentorship. In today's video, we are going to look at three more tips on how to spice up your presentation so that you can appear more elegant and professional in front of your audience. We'll look at how to use enhanced morph, how to create animated GIF, and most importantly, how to link our charts in Excel with PowerPoint. So if you're new here, kindly consider liking and subscribing to our channel to keep enjoying related useful videos from us. Now, why don't we jump into my PC to learn about these three tips today? Alright guys, so the first tip that we'll learn today is called enhanced morph. But before we go to enhanced morph, let us try to see how morph actually works. So let's say in this particular slide, I have this object or this shape that I just put and I want to morph it. So all I need to do is to duplicate this slide. And then I should try to move the same object from one place to another, for example. Alright. Now, when I select that second slide and go to transitions and I put morph, you can see the movement. So that is an ordinary morph. Okay. You can do that for a range of slides that have nearly the same content. Okay. So the algorithm has it that it follows the same content as it varies across slides. Okay. So in the cases when you have a different content, for example, you have a different shape or different object. Okay. Assuming this is a rectangle, we now have a circle. Okay. So let's say insert a shape and we can have maybe a circle. Right. So how do we morph this? Because when we go to transitions and put morph, nothing good happens. Okay. You can see nothing happens. For you to do an enhanced morph, all you need to do is to come back to the home page and navigate down here to this select icon and then hit on the drop down. You can see selection pane. Okay. Once you see the selection pane, you can see the definition of this object directly. So all you need to do is to rename it to add two exclamation marks before the name that you are going to give this object. Assuming, for example, double click and we call it an image, but then we'll have to put two exclamation marks before we put the name image. So let's say we copy this name and then we come to the next slide. We touch the same object so you can see the definition or it's level, so we can just double click and paste the same name, or we can give it the same image with the two exclamation mark before the name, right? So now this is called enhanced morph, because when you come to transition and click on morph, look at what happens. Isn't that fantastic? That is enhanced morph from one shape to another. Okay, the next tip is actually how to link your charts from Excel with PowerPoint so that anytime you adjust your Excel charts, you don't have to go copy them and take them back to Excel. They are already connected. As you tamper with the values, it will be automatically updated in the PowerPoint slides. This is a very handy tool for researchers and professionals who actually deal with charts in Excel and they give presentations every day. Okay. So assuming this is our chart and we want to take it to PowerPoint, all you need to do is to select it and do Ctrl C to copy it. Okay. Okay. So once you copy that particular chart, you come over here to your PowerPoint all you need to do is to navigate to this paste option over here, okay, and click on the drop down, and then you make sure that you paste using either of these two selections, okay, the one that contain the link data. Either you use the destination theme, you can keep the source format from the chart, or you can use the existing theme in the destination, that's the one in the PowerPoint. Use any of these two to paste your chart, and it is, be assured that it is linked with the one in the Excel. Now, if you want to edit this particular chart, all you need to do is to right click on it and click on edit data. It will bring you back to the Excel sheet. So assuming you want to make some changes here, like on this point A, you want to make it from 19 to maybe 5. And you can see the change. When you navigate to the Excel, you will notice that it has also changed. Okay, if you want to bring it back to 20 again, if you want to bring it back to 19, you notice the change. Once you go back to PowerPoint, you also notice that it has changed. So this is to tell you that this particular chart is linked with your Excel sheet. So whatever happens there, it will automatically be updated on this particular PowerPoint. Okay, so you can do this with all your charts in your PowerPoints. So to save your time from re-editing and re-pasting or recopying and pasting in the slide, all you need to make sure you note is that during the pasting time, make sure you select any of these two options. Okay, the next tip is how to create an animated GIF. Okay, animated GIF are extremely important for you to show some animations while you deliver your presentation. So let's say you want to create a sample animated GIF. All you need to do is to come over here to Insert, and maybe we'll go to Smart Art. And we can choose from these options. Let's say we are going with this gear icon. Okay. So we paste it, and then maybe we can rename it one. Maybe we name this two, and rename this three. Okay. So to create the animated GIF, all you need to do is to duplicate this slide. So you do Control D to duplicate the slide, and you are now on the second slide. Okay. So you come over to the first gear and try to move it either clockwise or anti-clockwise. But once you move it clockwise, you should move the second gear anti-clockwise. Okay, to those who know physics, they know how these gears operate. Okay. The third one also should go clockwise. Okay. So you duplicate this particular one, and you can still do the same movement. Okay, you move clockwise and you move anti-clockwise. Okay, and then you move clockwise. So once you are done, you can come over to File and go to Export. Once you're in Export, then you come to Create an Animated GIF. Okay, so you can choose the size or the file, the quality of the file. Okay, I usually go for 720p, which is quite good. And here you can make the background to be transparent if you want. Okay, and you can adjust the seconds it should spend on each slide. Okay, let's say I make it 0.05 seconds on this slide. Okay, from slide 1 to 3. Okay, we'll just say create GIF. All right, so we can navigate to the destination that we want to create it. Let's say in my desktop, and I call it presentation 1. Okay, save. Now to see this effect and how it works, all you need to do is to create a new slide. And let us make it a blank slide. It will come to layout, come to blank slide. All right, so let's insert that particular GIF that we just created. So all you need to do is come to insert and say we want to insert a picture from this device. Okay, we'll navigate to my desktop, and it's here. And then you insert it. Wow, look at that. Even though the speed is quite fast, but you get the idea. You can vary the speed on your own, and then you can use it for your presentation, regardless of what image or what shape or what idea you want to send to your audience. It's very easy to get them hooked with this kind of technique. All right, guys, thank you so much for being with me up to this point. And I do hope that you have learned something today. If you do, kindly feel free to share with your friends. And don't forget to always hit the like and subscribe button to keep enjoying related useful videos from this channel. Oh, I didn't forget. Now, regardless of the message, regardless of your delivery style, and regardless of the structure of your presentation, if you don't have audience connection, everything is useless. And your audience are going to look like this instead of this. So why don't you use some of these tips and tricks that I share to spice up your next presentation so that you can hook your audience from the beginning to the end of your presentation. Remember to hit the like and subscribe button to keep enjoying related useful videos from this channel. See you in my next video. Bye.